परम शांति, दिस इज द इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेटेड वीडियो ऑफ बापूजी ऑन द टॉपिक डू सोल्स रिसाइटिंग इन द सुप्रीम अबॉट हैव अ डिस्टिंक्ट पर्सनैलिटी एंड ड्यूटीज, व्हाट डू दे एग्जैक्टली डू देयर? काइंडली आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन बापूजी. बापूजी सेज, टुडे आई विल टॉक अबाउट द सोल्स इन द इनकॉर्पोरियल स्टेट हु रिसाइड्स इन द सुप्रीम अबॉट एंड देयर एक्टिविटीज. Souls reside in the incorporeal stage, that is the Nirakari state, in different dimensions of supreme abode, such as Paramdham of our solar system, Mahaparamdham, that is the supreme abode of our Mahashiv, the owner of one galaxy, the higher dimensional Paramdhams located in the universe, multiverse, or even in the upper distinct Paramdhams having the celestial power of lakhs or crores. So, I will discuss about the duties and the activities of such souls in such higher supreme abodes. Let us take the example of the souls living in the Paramdham of our Brahman, that is our solar system. These souls can observe, being in their incorporeal state, all the activities, events with great clarity that is occurring not only on our earth but also throughout the 14 lokas, that is, seven higher dimensions above from the earth and seven lower dimensions below the earth. These souls have the capacity to observe the minutest of details in every aspect to such an extent that even a grain of sand on the earth is visible to them in total clarity. The souls watch over all these dimensions below them with the help of their highly refined intellect, which we call as Buddhi Rupi TV. They do not have nor need any televisions or material aids for their observational activities, but through their own soul power. The powerful incorporeal state of the souls enable them to just think a single powerful thought about the happenings occurring in the entire Brahmand in any lok, be it on earth or on Swarglok, Mahalok, Janlok, Taplok, Brahmapuri, Vishnupuri, Shivpuri. They can even delight in or enjoy any such events observed by them. Similarly, the souls residing in Akari Roop, that is the higher subtle form in Shivpuri, can see the events happening in the dimensions below them, such as in Vishnupuri, Brahmapuri and down below. In the same way, one can also say that the resident souls of Vishnupuri, that is Vaikunth, souls residing in Brahmapuri, etc., all have the capacity to survey and experience any activity, reality of the dimensions below their own dimension, and if they wish to, take pleasure in the events. In short, each souls can see, observe, and even enjoy the happenings below their own dimensions of our solar system. In the case of Mahabrahman, that is one galaxy, the incorporeal souls living in the Mahaparamdham, incorporeal supreme abode of Mahashiv, that is the creator of one galaxy, all the activities occurring in the entire Mahabrahmand can be observed by these souls. However, not all souls get the permission to travel or reside in Mahaparamdham. Only those souls who are created by Mahashiv are allowed to reside here. Such souls situated in the incorporeal state in the supreme abode of the galaxy can not only observe the happenings of the galaxy but also the entire occurrence of all the solar systems located below them. These souls can view everything in detail in every solar system, or even view the infinite number of parallel solar systems all at the same time. Just like a supercomputer is powerful enough to perform enormous amount of transactions at one single time and also be able to communicate with all those linked to it, similarly, Mahaparamdham souls possess in their soul highly powerful intellect like a supercomputer that enables them to view in their intellect the Anant Koti Brahmand all at the same time and the entire galaxy too. In the same manner, we may say that the souls residing in the Paramdham of the universe, that is Param Mahabrahmand, can view and observe the happenings of the universe as also the events in any galaxy or in all the infinite galaxies at the same time. The souls of the universe have more than 16 to 20 kala and so are very powerful, whereas the souls residing in the Paramdham of the galaxy possess about 4, 5 to 6 or even till 8 kala. Therefore, one may note that all these souls are equipped with their own soul power consisting of supreme light and supreme radiance, so that whatever they wish to see in their domain, they can easily do so by observing infinite number of galaxies, their own universe all at once. Likewise, we can say the same about the great universes, great universes till G17 and also in the multiverse, where the souls residing in the Paramdham of the multiverse can observe the entire multiverse. However, there was a supreme abode above our multiverse which doesn't exist anymore at present. It can be the same about great multiverse souls in their supreme abode who can view the infinite number of multiverses below them all at one single time. These may be of 100 kala, 200, 500 kala, 1000 kala, etc. For example, the soul residing in the Paramdham of 1000 kala can observe the occurrences in the entire 1000 kala system as well as be able to view the infinite number of creations below it. The same process occurs for those souls staying in the Paramdham of 21 pd or 2100 kala, who can see whatever is happening in their own dimension and also the events in the dimension below 21 kala. 10,000 kala, 1 lakh kala or 1 crore kala. All can observe at one time their own dimensions, the infinite dimensions, star systems below them and all at once too. They can experience them and enjoy the activities. The Behat Kala Ka Paramdham or the souls residing in the infinite of the infinite supreme abode can see everything from top to bottom. All at once below them, for example, they can see our 100 kala multiverse and our earth experiencing it totally as the activity would be taking place in front of them, like a 3D television, as well as they can enjoy too. Thus, the souls in the incorporeal state may also form groups of 5000 or 10,000 souls to travel around their dimension and lower dimensions. However, most of these incorporeal souls do not travel out of their location. Instead, they have the power to experience the events or simultaneous events at one single moment. The joy they get out of traveling is hardly much compared to the happiness of viewing them from their intellect in their own abode. For example, the souls residing in 1 crore Kala Paramdham will rather opt to stay in their own home where they are always in the supreme divine bliss. So the souls of 1 crore kala being in the permanent state of 1 crore kala observe and enjoy the activities of whichever dimensions they choose to through their mind intellect, which acts like a television. They do not need a gross television set or any aids for their observation. Their soul power and sankalp is enough. The same can be said about the souls residing in the Paramdham of 100 crore kala. Such souls reside in pure supreme peace and supreme happiness of 100 crore kala. So, as one can see the stage of Paramanand and Param Shanti, one may say increases at every level. The souls of every increasingly higher level of Paramdham are always in the state of Paramanand, Nijanand, Divyanand Swarupam and in Param Shanti. These are progressively increasing states of divine bliss and supreme divine peace and are therefore different in different Paramdham. I have just indicated to you the rest of the matter is too deep to go into. Just indicated a sketch of these different levels. The Behat souls will go to the highest supreme abode of the infinite where they can observe the varying dimensions whichever they choose to and experience as well as enjoy the activities. The Behad souls will not venture for any travel to other dimensions below them or around. Instead, they will be able to observe the dimension of their choice situated in the infinite supreme abode of Behad Kala. Thank you so much. Behad ki param param param. Mahashanti hai, Mahashanti hai, Mahashanti hai.